Hi, this is your girl Wilma, and we're going to be studying the Word of God together in the King James Version, and I hope you enjoy. Oh yeah, and I hope you get a closer walk with God as we study the Word of God. Now turn to Ephesians chapter 5, and I think it's verse 1. Verse 1. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 1. Be ye therefore followers of God as dear children. You like that? Yes. Now, go to my notes here, and we'll be going to Matthew chapter 12, verse 34 in a few minutes. Okay. In the Passion Translation says, be an imitator of God in everything you do, for then you will represent your Father as he beloved as you are his beloved sons and daughters. So in the Bible it says to follow, and the Passion says be an imitator. Those two words really stood out to me. The word follow means to go and chase after something. So when we follow God's word, when we chase after it, we begin to change from the inside out. Matthew chapter 12 now. Okay, Matthew chapter 12. And it says, go to Matthew chapter 12, verse 34. And it says, O generation of vipers, how can you be an evil speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaketh. Okay. Yes, and it says, the mouth speaketh what the heart is full of. So what we are hearing and seeing the most is what's going to come out of us. And that's works both ways, good and bad. Now go to 1 Corinthians chapter 15. I'm going to go down to verse 33. And it says, let's see, where's 33? Go verse 33. I'm looking down at my Bible. Sorry. And it says, be not deceived, evil, communication corrupts good manners. That's what it said. Evil companions will corrupt good moral and character. Who or what we follow after the most is important when we choose to follow and chase after God by reading His Word, meditating on it, spending time in His presence. That's when we will become an imitator of God's by our actions, right? Recently, on my memories on my Facebook came a video of me with my daughter, and when she was a baby. And for weeks prior to that, I was trying to get her to say an oohs and ahs, and she finally was able to imitate me, and she started saying it. And I started to think about that on how it's the same with the Word of God. My daughter didn't just get the Word first. I said it to her. It took a few weeks of trying to get her to say it. So we don't just read His Word once or twice, because the imitator of Him, it takes time and spent. It takes someone who is willing to follow and chase Him more than anything else in this world. As we do, His Word changes us from the inside and out. And then we're able to go out and represent Him and allow Him to work in us and through us. Now, comment and say, okay? Lord, as I spend time in Your Word, let it change me from the inside and out, so that I can go and be Your representations in this world. In Jesus' name, amen. Yeah, and I hope our study is helping you have a closer walk with God.